فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. This is our third session and our third lecture on the topic root causes for deviation. So the first one, inshallah ta'ala, is al-dhunub, sins. Sins is from one of the root causes that bring about deviation. My beloved brothers and sisters, shu'mu dhunubi wal ma'asi ma'lumun. It's actually well known the harms and the evil effects that sins have and how it harms the heart of an individual, and it places on the person's heart taint, which then leads to the heart of the person becoming weak. Then it also then affects the person's aql, his rationality, his intellect, his thinking. And so when that happens, it corrupts the person's perception of things. He doesn't then start to perceive things as they are, let alone going out there to seek it and to look for it. He doesn't even perceive it correctly. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية رحمه الله, he said in his كتاب الإيمان, the 29th page, he says, كما أن الإنسان يغمض عينيه فلا يرى شيئا وإن لم يكن أعمى. Ibn Taymiyyah says, like that, if a person closes their eyes, he's not going to see anything, is he? Even if he's not blind. فكذلك القلب, the heart is like that. بما غشاه من غين الذنوب لا يبصر الحق. Like that is the heart. It can't see the truth because of the taint of sins that have covered it. وإن لم يكن أعمى كعمل الكافر. Even if he is not blind like the disbeliever. Because the disbeliever's heart is actually dead. He's blind, fully blind. But your heart is not blind. It's actually what? It closed its eyes. But what is it that which made the heart's eyes close? Here, you're using your eyelids, right? And that is what makes your eyes close. Your heart is what? The sins and the ma'asi. So that's why the alim, the great scholar, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, says, لا يبصر الحق, the person cannot see the truth, even if it's right in front of them. Ibn al-Qayyim رحمه الله, in his book, الداء والدواء, he says, فَإِنَّ الطَّاعَةَ نُورٌ, the obedience is light, وَالْمَعْصِيَةُ ظُلْمَةٌ, and the sins are darkness. وَكُلَّمَا قَوِيَةِ الظُّلْمَةِ وَازْدَادَتْ حَيْرَةٌ, and every time the darkness increases, the person's confusion also increases. A'udhu billah. SubhanAllah. He says, the obedience is light, and the disobedience is darkness. Every time the darkness increases, the confusion of the person increases. The person becomes more confused. حَتَّى يَقْعَ فِي الْبِدَعِ وَالضَّلَالَاتِ, until the person falls into innovation and misguidance. وَالْأُمُورِ الْمُهْرِكَةِ, and he falls into destructive issues, destructive matters. وَوَلَا يَشْعُرُ, and he doesn't feel it. كَأَعْمَى خَرَجَ فِي ظُلْمَةِ اللَّيْلِ يَمْشِي وَحْدَهُ, he is like a blind person walking in the darkness alone. So, with these two statements, from these two noble imams, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah and Ibn al-Qayyim al-Jawziyyah, what it teaches us and it tells us is that the harms and the evil effects that sins have, and it is a root cause in deviating from the people, the straight path. وَلِذَلِكَ الْكَرَابِيسِ, He said about Imam Ahmad, rahimahullahu ta'ala, this is transmitted by Ibn Rajab al-Hanbali in the Sharh of Ilal al-Tirmidhi. He has an explanation on it. Ibn Rajab, rahimahullah, he explained Sunan al-Tirmidhi, Abu Jami' al-Tirmidhi, all of it. Okay? He explained all of it. But qadarullah wa ma sha'a fa'al, we only received what? We only received the explanation of the chapter of Ilal in Sunan al-Tirmidhi. That's the only part which we received. Some of the scholars, they say that the loss of this book is mutayakkan. It's known by certainty. It's not from those books who are, those books which are missing. There, inshallah, might be a hope to find it. Because they say whilst the author was alive, he got burnt. So it's not shibhu fukdan. It's not partially lost. Some books are said to be lost and then they later be found. This book is actually lost. You see, it's like the book Al-Imam, what's he called? Al-Imam Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shaqiyati, rahimahullah, the book he wrote about Al-Ansab, lineages, the Arab lineages and whatnot. He himself said, I buried it. He got rid of it, he destroyed it. So for anyone to come about and find it is close to impossible. Yeah? So ala kulli hal, Al-Imam Al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, in his Ilal, Ibn Rajab, in the Sharh of Ilal al-Tirmidhi, the second volume, page 807, he brings a statement of Al-Karabisi that when he spoke about Imam Ahmad rahimahullah, he said the following. Pay attention. He said, Inna Aba Abdullah, who's Aba Abdullah? Ahmad ibn Hanbal. He said, Inna Aba Abdullah rajulun salihun. And Imam Ahmad is a righteous individual, a noble individual, a pious individual. Mithluhu yuwaffaqu li isabati al-haq. Somebody like him is guided to the truth. Someone like him is guided to the truth and is made to be upon the right path. But where did Karabisi use Al-Imam Ahmad rahimahullah deserving to be placed in the truth? Because he's a righteous person at the first point. So when you look at man tala'a as-siyarahum, if you look at the siyar of the salaf al-salih, the pious predecessors and their statements, you'll be fascinated in how they were when it came to staying away from sins. And one of the reasons why they stayed away from sins is because they understood that sins is what's a root cause from them deviating from the truth. وَلِذَلِكَ سُفْيَانِ بْنُ عُيَيْنَ رَحِمَهُ اللَّهِ, he said, as Imam al-Dhahabi rahimahullah brought in his kitab Siyara A'lam al-Nubala, that مَنْ عَمِلَ, anyone who implements بِمَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ, that which he didn't know, كُفِيَ بِمَا لَمْ يَعْلَمْ, anyone who implements that which he knows, Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala will bring about to him that which he didn't know. So if a person implements that which they know and they come with following it, then whatever is missing from them in terms of knowledge, Allah is going to bring it for them. Allah is going to suffice them in making sure that they gain the knowledge. Sins, on the other hand, sins not only does it not allow you to gain what's missing from you, but rather what it also does is that it actually destroys what's already there with you. What you already have, you're not even able to perceive it correctly. And it takes away barakatul intifa'i bi, the barakah of benefiting from your own knowledge that you have. ولذلك ابن مسعود رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, as وكيع بن جراح الرؤاسي, شيخ الإمام الشافعي رحمه الله, in كتاب الزهد, he has a book, كتاب الزهد, he said that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud رضي الله تعالى عنه, he said, إني I, Abdullah ibn Mas'ud is saying, لأحسب الرجل, I believe a man or individual, ينسى العلم, he forgets knowledge, كان يعلم, which he knew, لِخَطِيئَةٍ يَعَمَّلُهَا, because of a sin which he practices, a sin which he does. He forgets what he already knows. He loses what he already understood. The reason that happens to him is because he is practicing, he is doing a sin. لِذَلِكَ وَكِعْ himself سُوءَ الْإِمَامُ الشَّافِعِيُّ, and he said to him, as Imam Shafi'i mentioned himself, he said, "Shakawtu ila waki'in bisu' hifdhi." I complained to Waki' regarding the bad memorization that had befallen on me. فَأَرْشَدَنِي إِلَىٰ تَرْكِ الْمَعَاصِيَ And he guided me to leave it off the sins. وَقَالَ إِنَّ الْعِلْمَ نُورٌ He said to me, knowledge is light. وَنُورُ اللَّهِ And Allah's light is not gifted to the sinner. So this, my beloved brothers and sisters, is something we have to understand. Sins and being upon the truth are two things that contradict one another. And remember, the quantity of your sins is how much haq is missing from you. The more the sins increases, and the more your sins become, the more haq in which you are diverted from. Until your heart fully becomes tainted, you can't see any truth at all. And you fall into stubborn denial, just like the disbelievers. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah said something very powerful. He says, وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ جَعَلَ مِمَّا يُعَاقِبُ بِهِ النَّاسَ عَلَى الذُّنُوبِ سَلْبَ الْهُدَى بِالْعِلْمِ النَّافِعِ Ibn Taymiyyah said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made the things in which He punishes His creation and people with, when they come with sins, is to what? Strip them from guidance. Allah takes guidance away from them. وَالْعِلْمَ النَّافِعِ Allah also takes from them beneficial knowledge. And then Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah brings verses for this. He says, كَقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى Like the statement of Allah, وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا غُلْفٌ They said our hearts, these are the Jews, they said our hearts has locks on it. Allah says, no, بَلْ رَادَ That's not the truth. بَلْ رَادَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ Allah cursed them بِكُفْرِهِمْ Because they came with disbelief. The reason why there are locks on their hearts is because they came with a sin called Al-Kufr. So when they came with this sin called Kufr, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He sealed their hearts and placed locks on their hearts, which they are not now able to see. They are not able to see the truth. Also Allah said in another ayah, وَمَا يُشْعِرُكُمْ أَنَّهَا إِذَا جَاءَتْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ وَنُقَلِّبُ أَفْئِدَتَهُمْ وَأَبْصَارَهُمْ Allah says we seal their hearts and their eyes. They are not able to see the truth. Why? كَمَا لَمْ يُؤْمِنُوا بِهِ أَوَّلَ مَرَّةٍ At the beginning, at the first stage, they chose not to believe. So when they became hard and they were denying and they were argumentative, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that what He did was He placed a veil on their hearts. And He also placed a veil on their eyes. They were not able to see the truth. Also the Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, he brings qawluhu ta'ala, the statement of Allah, في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا ولهم عذاب أليم بما كانوا يكذبون. Allah says, في قلوبهم مرض, in their hearts, there is illness. And then Allah says, فزادهم الله مرضا. Then Allah increased them in illness. ولهم for them is عذاب أليم, a severe punishment. Why? بِمَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ Because they used to disbelieve. So this is things that they did prior to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala taking guidance away from them and beneficial knowledge. Also Allah says in the Quran, فَلَمَّا زَاغُوا أَزَاغَ اللَّهُ قُلُوبَهُمْ When they diverted and they deviated, Allah deviated their hearts. All of that Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah brings it in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 14th volume, page 152. And there are many verses in the Quran that point towards this issue, which is this issue of al-dhunub, falling into sins. Allah says in the Quran, Subhanahu wa Taala, وَلَوْ أَنَّا كَتَبْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ أَنِ اقْتُلُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ أَوْ اخْرُجُوا مِنْ دِيَارِكُمْ مَا فَعَلُوا إِلَّا قَلِيلٌ مِنْهُمْ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا إِذَا لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّا أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا وَلَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا In this verse, Allah tells us, وَلَوْ أَنَّهُمْ فَعَلُوا If only they did, مَا يُعَظُونَ بِهِ That which they are reminded with. لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ It would have been so much good for them. وَأَشَدَّ تَثْبِيتًا And it would have been from the things that would have made them solidified and rooted and grounded. وَإِذَنْ And once they did do that, Allah said, we would have brought to them, لَآتَيْنَاهُمْ مِنْ لَدُنَّا أَجْرًا عَظِيمًا Great and immense reward is what we would have given them. وَلَهَدَيْنَاهُمْ We would have also guided them to what? صِرَاطًا مُسْتَقِيمًا A straight path. You see, Allah also says in another ayah, وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ Allah tells us, those who are guided, Allah increased them in guidance. Allah also says in another ayah about the people of Kahf, and the young youths and these young boys, what did Allah say? إِنَّهُمْ فِتْيَةٌ آمَنُوا بِرَبِّهِمْ وَزِدْنَهُمْ هُدًى. They were young youths. Allah says they were young youths, believed in their Lord. Once they believed in their Lord, what did Allah say? وَزِدْنَهُمْ هُدًى. We increased them in guidance. Allah is now going to give them, because they've stayed away from sin, they've stayed away from disbelieving in Allah. They now deserve for their hearts to be protected, for them to be kept steadfast upon the truth, for them to be kept upright, and also to be shown the knowledge and the things which they didn't know. Those are now being opened for them. Also Allah said in the Quran, ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى فَهُلَكِ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ. The Quran's guidance for a person who has a what? Who has taqwa with him. But the Quran is read by many people. It's read by Christians, it's read by agnostics, it's read by atheists. And they don't find guidance in it as we would find guidance in it. Why is it that they don't get it? It's because al-dhurub, shukm al-dhurub wal-ma'asi, the harms and the effects of sins has blinded them to see what's in the Quran. Allah also says in another ayah, هَذَا بَصَائِرُ لِلنَّاسِ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمًا. Allah says the Quran has insight, it has mercy, it has what? Guidance. But for who? لِقَوْمِ يُوقِنُونَ. A people have certainty, a people whose heart is clean. Also Allah says in another ayah, هَذَا بَصَائِرُ مِنْ رَبِّكُمْ وَهُدًى وَرَحْمَةٌ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. Again, it is insight, and it's also guidance, and it's mercy for who لَكِنْ لِقَوْمِ يُؤْمِنُونَ. A people who come with belief. So from all of those statements and all of those evidences, what we will come to know, or what we've come to know, is the harms and the evil effects that sins have. And that it is from the root causes that divert. And because of it, a person becomes deviated from the truth and the path in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with. If we move on to the second root cause of today's lecture, it is al-ghafla an su'al al-hidayah. It is to be heedless of asking for guidance. One of the things why people are deviated, or they deviate, is because they don't ask Allah for guidance. My beloved brothers and sisters, if you sit down and you look at so many people who are misguided today, and you observe them, the people of your time right now, or even the people who came before us, if you look at them, a lot of the people who become misguided, you will find out a lot of them is that they were very smart people. They were not dumb. They were actually academically, they in their worldly affairs, they were smart people. They were geniuses, some of them. Ma'adhalik Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He didn't bring guidance to them. So what we know from that is فَالذَّكَاء وَحْدَهُ لَا يَكْفِي. Being smart, being a genius, alone by itself is not enough. And it doesn't take you, لا يقود صاحبه إلى الهداية والحق. It doesn't take the person to guidance and the truth. And Allah told us subhanahu wa ta'ala this particular issue. He says, وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَى. Allah guides whoever He will, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what we know is that the guidance is in whose hands? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The only people who come to realize that, this blessing of guidance, who realize that the guidance is in Allah's hand, and it is only Allah that can give it to us, is not those supposedly smart individuals that you see today. Because what has happened to them is that the dhaka, their smartness, their thinking, and their rationality, and their logic got to them so much that they believe everything that they want to attain, it's through their own actions. That they forgot that there is a Khaliq, al-Mudabbir, one who controls their affairs, and that everything is in his hand, subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the believer knows that, no. Even when he prays, he knows that the reason why he prays is what? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala permitted for him and gave him this blessing and bestowed his favor onto him to be a person to pray, right? لذلك our Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, al-Imam al-Bara' ibn Azib radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم ينقل معنا التراب يوم الأحزاب. That the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he was moving the sand and the dust with us the day of Ahzab. ولقد رأيت وار التراب بياض بطنه. And I saw the dust cover the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's abdomen. Yaqulu, the Prophet was saying, Lawla anta, if, oh Allah, if it wasn't for you, mahtadayna, we would not have been guided. Wala tasaddaqna, we would not have given charity. Wala sallayna, and we would not have prayed. Our Messenger was saying this, alayhi salatu wasalam. Lawla anta, if it wasn't for you, oh Allah, mahtadayna, we would not have been guided. Wala tasaddaqna, and we would not have given out charity. Wala sallayna, and we would not have prayed. So the Messenger alayhi salatu wasalam is what? In recognition and understanding of what? بِنِعْمَةِ اللَّهِ, Allah's blessings. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's favors upon him alayhi salatu wasalam. And because of that, my beloved brothers and sisters, it is necessary for a student of knowledge, it is necessary for a Muslim to do what? طَلَبُ الْهِدَايَةِ, asking Allah for guidance. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is what? Al-alim, he's a knowledgeable one. Al-hakim, he's the one who judges everything. In which the disputes that we see today and the arguments that we see that are out there today, Allah is going to judge each and every one of it. And Allah is the one who knows which one is speaking the truth. So what you need in a time like this, where everybody's claiming that I am right and everyone else is wrong, you need at a time like this, su'alul hidayah, asking Allah for guidance. ولذلك شيخ الإسلام ابن تيمية في الكتاب الصفدية he says the first volume page 205 he says the following he says وقد يشكل الشيء ويشتبه أمره في الابتداء some matters may become ambiguous and unclear to you at the beginning فإذا حصل الاستعانة بالله but when the person seeks help and aid from Allah واستهداؤه ودعاؤه and he asks Allah for guidance and he supplicates to Allah والافتقار إليه and he shows Allah that he's in need of Allah أو سلوك طريق الذي أمر بسلوكها or he treads on the path in which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded him to tread path, to tread on هدى الله Allah then guides him هدى الله الذين آمنوا لما اختلفوا فيه من الحق بإذنه Allah guides those who believe But those individuals, Allah guides them to what? He guides them to the disputes that are out there. Allah guides them to the right path of it. The disputes that are out there, the khilafat that are occurring, which of the one is that is right is what Allah guides him to. وَاللَّهُ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ إِلَى صِرَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ And Allah guides whoever He wills to the straight path. انتهى كلامه. The statement of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah finishes there. Also, Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah went on to say, وَحَقِيقَةُ الْأَمْرِ The reality of the matter. This is another, the first one, Shaykh al-Islam Taymiyyah said it in his Safadiyya. The second one, he said it in Majmu'u al-Fatawa, the fourth volume, page 39. Fourth volume, page 39. Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah says, عَلَيْهَا رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَحَقِيقَةُ الْأَمْرِ And the truth of the matter, the reality of this issue is, أَنَّ الْعَبْدَ مُفْتَقِرٌ إِلَى مَا يَسْأَلُهُ مِنَ الْعِلْمِ وَالْهُدَى طَالِبٌ سَائِلٌ The reality of the matter is that the slave is in need in asking when it comes to knowledge and guidance, asking Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. فَبِذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَالْإِفْتِقَارِ إِلَيْهِ يَهْدِيهِ اللَّهُ وَيَدُلَّهُ When showing Allah tabarak wa ta'ala that you're in need of Him, Allah guides you and He shows you the straight path. كما قال as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in Hadith al-Qudsi Ya عبادي, my slaves كلكم ضالون each and every one of you are misguided إلا من هديته except the one in which I guide فاستهدوني ask me for guidance أهديكم I will guide you وكما كان النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم يقول and the way that the messenger used to excessively say اللهم رب جبريل وميكائيل وإسرافيل فاطر السماوات والأرض عالم الغيب والشهادة أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون اهدني لما اختلف فيه من الحق بإذنك إنك تهدي من تشاء إلى صراط مستقيم The messenger used to open his قيام الليل with this dua and he would say Oh the Lord of Jibreel, Mikael and Israfil The Lord of this universe, the Samawat and the Earth, the Earth The one who knows the unseen and who knows everything that's taking place أنت تحكم بين عبادك فيما كانوا فيه يختلفون Oh Allah, you're going to judge between your slaves the disputes and arguments that arises and comes up. So what do you want from Allah? اهدني, guide me. To what? لِمَخْتُلِفَ فِيهِ That which the people dispute in. Guide me to what? مِنَ الْحَقِّ The one that is right. بِإِذْنِكَ With your own will and your own permission. إِنَّكَ تَهْدِي Oh Allah, you're the one who guides. Who do you guide? مَنْ تَشَاءُ Whoever you wish. إِلَى صَلَاطٍ مُسْتَقِيمٍ Ibn Taymiyyah also said in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the fifth volume, page 118, Ibn Taymiyyah says, فَإِذَا افْتَقَرَ الْعَبْدُ إِلَى اللَّهِ If the slave shows need, and he humbles himself to Allah تبارك وتعالى, وَأَدْمَنَ النَّظَرَ فِي كَلَامِ اللَّهِ وَكَلَامِ رَسُولِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وَكَلَامِ الصَّحَابَةِ وَالتَّابِعِينَ وَأَئِمَّةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ انْفَتَحَ لَهُ طَرِيقَ الْهُدَى Ibn Taymiyyah says, if the person shows need of Allah تبارك وتعالى, and he looks at the statement of Allah consistently, repetitively and repeatedly. He looks at the speech of Allah, and he looks at the speech of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and he also looks at the speech of the companions, and the speech of the students of the companions, وَأَئِمَّةِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ And he also looks at the speech of the Muslim scholars, and the Muslim leaders, إِنْ فَتَّحَ لَهُ طَرِيقَ الْهُدَى The path of guidance is then opened for him. And he feels and he comes to guidance. And as you all know, Nabiullah Musa alayhi salat wa salam. Nabiullah Musa alayhi salat wa salam. Nabiullah Musa alayhi salat wa salam. When he ran from Midian, but he didn't know the path to take. He didn't know the path to Midian. And he didn't know how to get there. What did he say? He said, عَسَى رَبِّي أَن يَهْدِيَنِي سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ Perhaps, my Lord will guide me to the straight path. He didn't just say that, but he worked. He moved, he left from one city to another, and he made his way there until he what? He found a wife, he got paid, and he found a job. You see, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave him. Why? How did he gain that? عَسَى رَبِّي أَن يَهْدِيَنِي سَوَاءَ السَّبِيلِ Nabiullah Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام He showed an iftiqar ila Allah. He showed that he was in need of Allah. And that matters was not in his hands. And all the prophets, you will also always see that they always asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and their connection was with who? With Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So if the person doesn't have these characteristics, and these characteristics is my beloved brothers and sisters, the characteristics of asking Allah for guidance. This, my beloved brothers, it is from the root causes that misguide or diverts a person from the straight path.